I think I start with the most serious problem, and one that has received nothing like enough attention, which is the whole issue of local print journalism, the death of local print journalism, effectively, and the growth of monopoly at a local level. I mean, I've seen this locally, and many of you have in my part of London. We used to have a local newspaper, I think 70 years ago, a very good local newspaper, happened to be owned by the Dimbleby Group, with a large team of journalists, very professional, very well informed, a local journal of record. Now it's all gone, and we have a newscast freebie, with I think one or two journalists covering about three different boroughs. You know, and that's happened across the country. The question is, what can we do about it? Because you can't bring back the past, you can't put the digital genie back in the bottle. So, you know, what do we do about this? There are some interesting ideas around. I'll just summarize them. Other people will talk about the practicalities. There's a very good Res Publica essay by a man called Justin Schlossberg. And what he advocates, this seems basically sensible to me, is a small levy on the main media providers which aggregate news, like Facebook, Google, Microsoft, apply a small levy and use the levy for funding a media plurality organization, independent obviously of government and the media owners themselves, and using it to finance local journalism, particularly in new and innovative providers or where there is a yearning and a great need for investigative journalism at a local level. I should add that they weren't just making recommendations about the private sector. They were also very highly critical of the BBC because its news management is very, very highly concentrated, and they argued for decentralisation there too.